get on your Facebook, the Lord said, and don't talk about you, but you talk about him. He said, I'll applaud you. I'll prove. I heard the Lord said, tell them you're doing all right. Those of you that forget about yourself and don't try to promote your character or what you're doing, but talk about me, because I sent my son to talk about me, and I told you to talk about my son. Those of you that walk the street corner and you don't try to promote you're not looking for a reputation for yourself, but you talking about Jesus. You talking about my son. He said, I applaud you. I strengthen you. I said, arise in the name of Jesus and live. And live, because Lord God Almighty says he's with you. Listen, he said this, let the Lord be magnified, which have pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. I heard the Lord say, prosperity don't begin in your pocketbook. Prosperity don't begin in your home or car. I heard the Lord say, prosperity don't begin in what you wear, but prosperity begins in your heart. That's why I said, I would above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul, as long as your soul is hungry for me. If you panting like the deer for what? If you looking for truth, if you won't be denied, I don't care who talk about you, who put you down. He said, I want you to stand, having done all to stand. Why? Because I'm going to work inside of you. I give you the power to tread soft. I give you the power to promote my word. I, the Lord thy God, is speaking unto you. Oh, Jesus. Whew. He said, in my tongue. See, when you understand prosperity begins in your heart, when your car break down, you don't get mad. I know some folk done bought cars, but they ain't here today. But one day that car gonna break down. One day that car gonna need some help. And somebody gonna have the money for that car. I know somebody that done put prosperity in the eyesight of a car. I know somebody done put prosperity in the eyes of a new house. Oh, I got a raise now. I'm making more money now. But God said, that ain't prosperity. That's only temporary. Prosperity begins when in your soul you feel good. Your spirit is thinking about me. You're longing for my word. You're longing for my truth. I don't care what nobody have done or said. You still hungry for me, says God. That's prosperity. Prosperity is the soul that wake up in the middle of the night and said, thank you, Jesus. Why you laying in the bed? That rise up in the morning and say, Lord, I'm happy. I'm saved. Oh, Jesus. Listen, he said, in my tongue shall speak of thy righteousness and of thy praise. Woo. You know, when God is in your heart, you stop talking about people in a negative way. You stop lying on people. You stop backsliding. You wake up in the morning, it is just Jesus. The world can't understand it. Why? Because every time you turn around, they're saying, you're saying the same thing. But you know what? It's just like baking a new cake every day. Every time you say Jesus, it's brand new again. It's brand new. Why? Because whenever you say Jesus, the demons and the devils flee. The backslider don't like you. The wicked got to get away from you. They don't want to party with you. But when you say Jesus, it brings attention to everybody. Oh, God. I heard the Lord say, everybody ain't saved. every sanctuary I don't live in. I ask the question, why? They don't know me. Like the Pharisees, they don't know me. When you see these preachers behind the pulpit talking about worldly things and preaching, not preaching Jesus, they don't know him. They're going to preach what they know. A dollar bill. Why? Because they don't know Jesus. They don't know that a soul is not bought for ransom. They haven't understood that a soul deliverance is not based on things that are corrupt, but incorrupt. The word of God. They haven't understand. They don't love Jesus like some of you. Because if you love Jesus, you will tell the truth. If you love Jesus all day long, you will be thinking about him. Why? Because there's a built-in mechanism called the Spirit of God that dwells inside of you. That's why the Bible says you got to be born again. You're not born of flesh. Just because your mama and daddy had you don't mean you're going to heaven. Oh, God. When you look around and see what's going on, America's not a godly nation. And you got people using God's name for their own benefit. And you know what? You know who receive it? The ignorant. The folk that don't know. That's why the Bible said, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. You got some so-called Christian agree with everything. But let me tell you, when you're a real Christian, when you're a fighter, you stand. You take a stand. And you say, wait a minute. My Bible don't say that. I don't care how many of you rise up. I'm going to stand with Jesus. I'm going to stand with word. Why? Because I don't want to stand before him. And he asked me, why? Why didn't you serve me? Why didn't you believe my word? Why you turn your back on me? Why you forsake me? Why you gave up me? Why? No, I'm not going to do that. Sometimes I cut the TV on gospel station. You have to turn it off because of the wickedness on there. And some of you think just because a man said, you need to find out whether the word said. A man can say anything. You got people worshiping men instead of worshiping the word. You look around. That's why your children now are ignorant of the word of God. Why? Because they learn about it in their textbooks. Every day they go to school, that school teacher, that light, that book is an antichrist. What you mean? I'm not talking about those that are saved, but those that are not saved. That's why you got folks saying education is more important than spiritual redemption. Education can't save you. It might teach you how to read or write, but the Lord give you the ability to do the right. Jeez. He give you the ability to think. You look around now, I ask the Lord, why? You look around at all these preachers, all these so-called well-known preachers, can come on these talk shows that promote homosexuality, lesbianism, and talk about other gods and won't rebuke them and call them, they're devils. They're not, the Lord said they're false preachers. And you got a bunch of them. That's right. And then you got the so-called false Christians. Won't read your Bible for yourself, but you want to tell everybody else how to live. I asked the Lord, why? Why, Lord? Why don't you speak to the nations? Why? Why don't you? They won't hear me. They won't hear me. You look in your child's textbooks and see how many sinners in your books that promote Jesus Christ as the only Savior. You look in your child's textbook that see how many times your child textbook said, ask your child, did you worship the Lord this morning? Did you look in your child's textbook and you ask them, where is it in your textbook where the Lord, where they promote you and tell you Jesus is the only? You look in your child's textbook and then you wonder why your child act the way they act. And then you sit there and you won't teach them the right way. You think it's going to be like a magic wand. No, you got to train them. I asked the Lord why. And finally, God told me this. He said, all nations, again, all nations that forget God will go to hell. That's including your nation. That throne. They get up there and they argue about everything else. They won't talk about Jesus. They talk about Muhammad, and then they want you. They want you to compromise. I ain't compromised with no demon or devil. I'm not compromised with you backsliders. You markers, I'm not compromised with you. I want you to know there's a difference between me and you. I don't mark the word. I stand on it. And I ain't backing down for none of you. When you become a Christian, you rise up. When you begin to know God and know he has made you, you find out, wait a minute here. Holy, it wasn't my mom and dad. So if my mom and dad tell me, just because you went to a backslidden so-called church don't mean I have to stay there. Just because you went to a ministry where the blind lead the blind, I ain't got to stay there. I find out who made me. It wasn't you. Mom, you just carried me. Dad, the seed came from you, but it was God that gave you the seed. I found out it's God. I know who made me, and I ain't changing. I don't care whether I sound mean. I'd rather sound mean and be right than to fill you with flattery and lies. Mm-mm. They call Jesus mean. They call him a hard man. Why? Because he stood up for what's right. You look around today. How many of them preachers you see on TV talk about righteousness? How many Christians you see out there in them streets trying to give people Jesus instead of trying to do everything else? Jesus. It's amazing what goes on. And then you got some people like that woman on Fox, agree with everything. Call herself a Christian. She agree with Beyonce, JC, everything. Old man came on there and wrote a book about Adam and Eve. Talking about the good side. You know, wait a minute here. Adam and Eve, that's why we in this mess. What good side? And she going to put, oh, that's a good book. Wait a minute here. That's a lying book. Why? It goes against God's word. Why? Because they went against God's word. But you got all that stuff. And I wouldn't be surprised it end up in y'all books before long. Why? Because the devil, like Jesus said, the devil is the prince of this world. That's why I know all of you wicked. All of you wicked, we ain't alike. I serve another God. I don't serve an idol. I don't bow down to human beings, not even myself. I let the word govern me. Jesus. You know why? Because I'm learning about somebody higher than me. I found out that Donald Trump is the president, but that's all he is. God is the God. And Jesus Christ is my king. You look at these churches, oh God, these so-called churches get up and write out a sermon that don't change nobody. Jesus. Can't hear from the Lord, and everybody flocked to him. Why? Because the Bible said it was going to be like that in the last days. They got itching ears. They don't want to hear sound doctrine. Tell me something to make me feel good so I can go about my daily activity doing what I want to do. Being my own God. Why? Well, I want you to know I got a God. So all of you to try to tell me something, I got a God. I don't need you to be my God. Not only am I behind the wheel, but I'm listening to my God. I don't care, you husbands and wives. Jesus, just like I tell mine, she can go wherever she want to go. I'm going to heaven. I ain't going to let none of you stop me. None of you. My grandchildren, none of you. You ain't going to stop me. I'm determined, whether you like it or not, I'm going to see Jesus. And I'm not going to see him any kind of way. I'm going to see him the right way. Because some of you are going to see him the wrong way. I don't have idols. I just got Jesus. Whether you like what I do, I couldn't give a hill of beans. So I don't care how many of you get on Facebook or your book. or anybody else's book. I'm going to tell the truth. And it's Jesus. Why? All these folk, all throughout history, even when Israel backslid, God would speak to the nations. God ain't speaking to this nation. And it's not because we got the word either. God just ain't speaking because of the pride and arrogance of this nation. And God gonna punish preachers. All these prideful preachers, oh, God gonna deal with them. Just cause you send your little money, they ain't gonna stop them. God gonna deal with them. Why? Cause see, we supposed to be messengers. We supposed to deliver what's written. We don't supposed to come up with our own agenda. Lord Jesus, I heard the Lord say, save yourselves from this wicked and untoward generation. You know what that means? It means not only are they wicked, but they bold with their wickedness. Like some of you, when you leave here, you like to mar God's righteousness because you bold in your wickedness. Your day coming. Oh, it's coming. It's coming. Why? The word says it's coming. When you're a child of God and you love the Lord, in your heart, you humble yourself. Why? Because you know you ain't your God. You know you don't have, you might run your mouth, but you don't have the last word. Lord Jesus, why? Why? And then I heard the Lord say it's going to get worse for the world. Why? Because they perish. Go back to 1 Corinthians, we're going to close, because they're perishing. I'm going to tell you, if you are saved, you shouldn't give up your salvation for nothing or nobody. That's if you're really saved. And if you saved, you have a hunger for the truth. You know, that's why I don't beg nobody to stay here. You know why? Because I'm going to tell the truth. I wasn't sent here to beg you to stay. I was sent here to preach the gospel. Whether you believe it or not, I'm going to tell the truth. And whatever you get from here, it's going to be from the word. If I got anything to do with it, and it's going to be rightly divided. You know why? First of all, I love God. I love God. I love myself, and then I love you. Because I ain't going to hell. I'd rather see your mad, angry face than to be in hell. Oh, Jesus. I'm telling you. I don't care how you get mad you get with me, I'm going to tell you the truth and tell you to go home and read it for yourself. Listen, 1 Corinthians 1, verse 19, he said, for it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent, those that seem wise. I'm going to bring people. A day coming when a day ain't gonna be like it normally is. A reckoning day coming. And man is not gonna be in charge of it. The U.S. government has nothing to do with it, nor any other government. There's a reckoning day coming when the sky's gonna open up and God gonna move. And everything gonna stop. No matter how much pride and arrogance you and your group got, it's going to be based on when God says. The weatherman ain't going to be able to tell you what time it is, or day, or the weather condition. And when you look around, the church is supposed to be the light. When you leave here, how many Christians you ran into this week that was out there telling people about Jesus? How many of them did you run into? But we got all these God-forsaken churches, so to speak, that's supposed to be training the people to be lights that sit on a hill. Have you ever read that? Is that in your Bible? Well, why we don't see many lights? People so caught up in themselves and their glory, they ain't got time. Paul said they seek their own glory and not the glory of God. See, when you seek your own glory, you ain't got time for Jesus. Why? You caught up in your own career. And your career messing you up. Why? Because your career just became your God, your idol. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. And those of you that education is your God, I'm going to make a ways you with you. You get lost in your education. I'm going to get lost in Jesus. And let's see who's going to come out on top. Now, don't get me wrong. Children need to learn. But you need to put more emphasis on their spiritual life. Because, see, Hesper High School ain't going to be here for long. Glen Hill, oh Lord God, is going to be gone. Tell it like it is. You got a bunch of educators that you let you go to school every day, and most of them are devils. Don't know the Lord. Caught up in their education, in their scientific theory, and it's too stupid to understand who created them. That's why they don't want prayer in public school. Now you can sit there all you want to. I'm gonna tell the truth. I'm not like some of these backslidden preachers that God calls them dogs, Cain Bar. I'm gonna tell the truth. Because I know the truth makes you free. Jesus. I asked the Lord, why? It really troubled my spirit. Why, Lord? Going through the books of the prophets, God spoke to the nations. And don't tell me because we got the New Testament. They had the law. And God still spoke. And then in the New Testament, he told us he will come and speak to us. But he ain't speaking to the nations. Look at this nation. Look how backwards this nation is. If your eyes are open, look how backwards this nation is. People, when you come to a place, you can't tell the difference between a man or a woman. You done messed up. How you gonna guide me and you don't know who's who? When you can't tell them between right, and then you got preachers coming on radio talking about you shouldn't judge. Well, then they ought to stop preaching. Because you know they preaching to judge. He said the word is the judge. So, they ain't preaching the word. Because see, when you preach the word, that's the judge. Jesus. So they ain't preaching the word. You tell all them backslidden dogs, apostles, but they ain't preaching the word. Because if you preach the word judging. That's why folk don't like it. That's why some of you don't like it. Why? The word judges us. And I said, Lord, judge me now because I don't want to be judged later. Folk, I want to be approved of later. You judge me now. Let me get myself right now. Because I know at the end, you won't give me time to get right. There's no recess. There's no purgatory. Oh, God. And don't let us get on Catholicism. Purgatory. Priests. Not even in the Bible. Look at these backslidden, blind people. God said, that's your why. Got somebody call themselves a priest. Claiming to speak for God, don't even know God. And this gonna be aired, whether you like it or not. It's the truth. Then some of you, you leave here and don't ever think about the Lord until you show back up. Don't realize, God said, I want you to know it was me that made you. Those of you that know it, the Holy Spirit was dealing with you every day. He's doing exactly what Jesus told him to do. He's ministering to you every day, keeping you aware of the Savior and the truth. He's looking out for you. Oh, God. Lord Jesus. Jesus. Go back to Psalms. We're going to close. Let me tell you something. It's a joyous day when you are a real Christian. I'm not talking about a churchgoer, because I wasn't sent to churchgoers. I was sent to preach to people so they can become the church, so they can go. That's why I was sent. And I heard the Lord say, don't lose your mission. See, the Lord gave me a mission before I knew you. And I'm not going to lose sight of my mission. That's why I thank God for this ministry. You know why? Because when you come here, you're going to get nothing but the. That's all you're going to get. And it can be subject to any backslidden preacher. Like Paul said, who are you to judge me? You don't preach the truth and you're going to judge me? Who are you? Jesus. In the book of Psalms, listen to this. Psalms 101, verse 7 says, he that works deceit shall not dwell within my house. He that tell lies shall not tarry in my sight. I will early destroy all the wicked of the land, that I may cut off all the wicked doers from the city of the Lord. The Lord took me to that scripture this morning. Oh, I'm going to mess some of y'all up now.
Thank you for joining us today. We hope that the word has truly blessed your life. Come back soon and be blessed in Jesus.